Today, let's take a look at how we can quickly create a histogram chart in Excel. First of all, what is a histogram good for? Well, it's great for checking how the data is spread within a range. So for example, you want to understand the salary distribution within your company. You can use a histogram chart to find the number of people who earn a salary within a specific range. This makes histograms great for cases when you have data with large value ranges and you'd like to understand the distribution. When you use an Excel histogram, you can also set and adjust your own data ranges, which are also called bins. Let's set one up from scratch. So in this case, we're taking a look at salary distribution. We have specified these groupings here, and we can quickly tell that 15 people fall in the 30,000 to 70,000 salary range. We have two people that earn less than or equal to 30,000 and one person earning more than 200,000. Let's make this from scratch. Here's our data set. We have the employee names, their entry date, and the yearly salary. So based on this, I want to create a histogram chart. All I'm going to do is highlight the data, go to Insert, and insert the histogram. Now you might be fine with the standard histogram chart that you get, but you probably will want to adjust the bins here, because what Excel does is it tries to automatically guess the best fitting range based on your data set. But you might want to analyze the data in different ranges. You can specify that in the options. So just activate the axis by just clicking on it and bring up the axis option so you can use the shortcut key Control-1. Right here, we can see it's set to automatic, but we can decide on the bin width, which means the width of the range here. So instead of 53,000, I'm going to change that to 40,000 and press enter. Immediately, I can see that the number of bins changed to 6. It would also be nice to have the ranges rounded to thousands. I can control that, so I can define the overflow and the underflow bin. For overflow bin, which means the highest point that I want to have here, is something I'm going to manually set. So I'll change that to 200,000 and press enter. For the underflow bin, I'm going to change that as well. So instead of minus 62,000 default that it has, I'll change it to 30,000 and press enter. Now my ranges look a lot neater. All I have to do is to activate the data labels. So select the series, right mouse click, add data labels. Let's make them a bit bigger so they stand out more and make them bold. Now I can remove the axes, remove the grid lines, and I'm done. And all of this is automatic. So if I take Paul Hill out of this range here, so let's say he gets a demotion and he goes down to 20,000 and I press enter, the first range automatically increases and the second range decreases. If you're already using histograms in your files, comment below and let us know what you're using it for. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe in case you haven't subscribed already. And I'm going to see you in the next video.